Hello everyone, welcome back to a new episode of Voice of Cards. Last time we left off, we found out this village is likely important to Ash in some way, and I also believe Winifred is right here, so hello Winifred.
You spot a familiar-looking mage on the village streets. Winifred takes no notice of you and ducks into the apothecary. So, the Ivory Order buys their medicine just like everybody else. You muse to yourself as you prick up your ears and listen carefully.
No, they probably sell their shitty meds here.
Winifred and the apothecary speak in hushed tones. You'd guess it's an order for special medicine, but you can't make it out. Alas, she's just buying the usual stuff. Nothing remotely interesting about that. Though her presence suggests that other members of the Order might also be in town. With no desire to run into them, you make yourself scarce before she catches sight of you.
Yeah. I mean, I jumped on top of her. I'm surprised she didn't see us. Alright, where are we supposed to go? Ah, down there. Should I try... You know what, I really just don't want to try the game parlor again. I've gotten my ass handed to me too many times.
You spy the very people you were hoping to avoid, gathered near the village gate. The last thing we need is a confrontation, you mutter, spying them from the shadows. Why are we always hiding? Melanie hisses under her breath.
Because they'll probably kick our asses.
Two members of the Order are speaking with Sherwin. Giving how deferential they appear to be acting toward him, you hazard a guess that he's their superior. Have you determined the dragon's location? Sherwin asks. Hedwin launches into his report. The dragon appears to be occupying the volcano. I suggest we move to capture him immediately, he counsels. Now who should appear but Winifred, fresh from her shopping excursion? Preparations for our journey into the volcano are complete, she reports, handing Sherwin a bottle of something.
It was a bottle of flash freeze, I saw that.
Splendid. Sherwin walks off and out of sight, the other three following close behind.
Alrighty.
Lucky for you, your hastily improvised hiding spot afforded you valuable information on the dragon. Yet their conversation raised as many questions as it answered.
What about that medicine bottle?
The medicine bottle Sherwin received is probably related to their journey into the volcano somehow.
You might need it so that you don't just die from the heat.
Bruno recalls seeing a bottle much like it once before. He says it contains flash freeze, which can chill most anything. Maybe that's what Winifred bought at the apothecary, Bruno continues.
If their conversation raises many questions... Oh, okay. How do we get to the volcano?
You know that the dragon is lurking in the volcano, but you haven't a clue how to get from here to there. Isn't it that mountain with all the smoke pouring out of it? Rittus asks, pointing westward. Why, yes. That sure does look rather like a volcano.
Okay, capture the dragon?
There was talk of capturing the dragon. Melanie picked up on the incongruity as well. The queen ordered the dragon killed, she reminds you. You narrow your eyes. You three have no right being this helpful, you think? Mar pinches your cheeks without warning. You yelp in pain, which at the very least crosses dreaming off the list of explanations.
Yup. Thanks for the pinch, Mar.
Turning to the matter at hand, it's clear what must be done. You'll have to get your hands on some flash freeze if you hope to enter the volcano.
Acquire some flash freeze from the village of the sick apothecary. Alright. Gimme, gimme.
Happen to have any flash freeze for sale? You cheerily ask the apothecary. She flashes a wry smile. How do you steady the roiling magma's flow? She asks cryptically. The meaning behind the question is utterly lost on you. She needs a password, Melanie mutters over your shoulder. The answer, then, would be the password. So, how do you steady the roiling magma's flow?
Tugging on a card ever so slightly may reveal what it contains. Cold ice, flowing water, special medicine. Old woman rolls her eyes, suddenly looking defeated. Mm-hmm, she mutters softly. Ah, yes, you'd think so, she says. As if turning the... Okay. I say special medicine? She rolls her eyes, suddenly looking defeated. Maybe that's wrong? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, she mutters softly. I feel like it might be flowing water, because her rolling her eyes seems, I don't know. Looking defeated, like, I feel like that's either she's rolling her eyes because why would she roll her eyes if I did get it right? Plus, that's obvious, like, right? I feel like that's too obvious. Special medicine, but she rolls her eyes looking defeated, like, I can't believe this person's that much of an idiot. But this one she says, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, softly. Like, I'm thinking it's flowing water. Ow.
She mutters softly. Alas, no. She pulls out her wares, but what you need is not among them. Your password merely granted you entry to the apothecary.
Oh, shit. Maybe I was supposed to say special medicine because that's what Winifred said earlier. Wait, what? What am I doing here? Oh, this is just the shop. Okay. Okay, let's just try again. I think it's just special medicine. I think I was trying to overthink that. Special medicine.
The old woman rolls her eyes, suddenly looking defeated. How did you know the answer? Did someone tell you? She mutters bitterly.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, the old woman rolls her eyes, suddenly looking defeated, and then she'd be like, I can't believe someone's that dumb. It's so obvious. That's the obvious answer, but no, apparently that was the right one. I don't know, I was overthinking it. I thought it was gonna be something, I don't know. I thought it was a red herring, basically. There it is. Comment allows you to freeze most anything momentarily. Handle with care. We probably need it to, like, cross the lava, but the lava would still burn us alive when we got inside, just due to the heat, because it's very hot inside a volcano. Whatever, let's not think about that. Alright, let's go.
You've managed to crack the code, and a bottle of flash freeze is yours. At last, you are ready to enter the volcano.
Journey to the volcano.
You've got a long road ahead of you, so you had best be prepared.
Okay, that sounds like a warning. Luckily, I haven't really had any problems with running out of items or anything in this game thus far, so I think we're good. I do believe we are just dandy. Yeah, boy. I like the music that plays here on this world map.
The heat of the volcano engulfs you the moment you set foot inside.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Of course, the dragon is hiding out here. Guess it's as good a place as any to corner him. You reason with yourself, trying to keep your spirits up.
Yeah, this would, like, cook us. Alright. Oh, so yeah, we needed to cross the lava here, right?
Crossing this river of lava won't be easy.
Do you know a way across? Yes, I do. I do.
Here's how you cross a lava river. Bam.
Freeze the lava.
You open the bottle of flash freeze and pour some into the raging river of lava. The lava instantly hardens, forming a bridge of rock.
Yeah, boy. ascend the volcano in pursuit of the dragon. I feel like we might have to fight the Ivory Order here. Possibly. So, I don't know which way's up. I'm gonna check both paths, though. Alright, what sort of enemies are hiding out in the volcano? Let's see. What do we got? Magma jellies. Wind damage. Not super useful to me, but, cool. Are you weak to freeze? The lava was weak to freeze, so you should be too, right? I think so, yep. Cool. Alright, and I'm gonna loose an arrow at you. There we go. Excellent. Ooh, fire resistance down. That's gonna be painful. Ow. Elemental resistance down, take 5 damage. Yeah, that's fine. Alright, hit him with a spinning ray. That should finish both of the slimes off. Maybe not the one on the right. Yeah, just barely not enough. But I did finish that one off. Ow, Melanie, that looks like it hurt. Alright, let's just attack. Oh, I should have done fireball with you, but whatever. You'll both die anyway. Let's set you both up to be killed by spinning ray. the slime's faster than ash though, so
that was lucky.
Ash is probably gonna take some extra damage here because I waited too long. Yep. Ow. Yeah, I should have just killed the slime. It felt like a waste because the slime only had 2 HP. But whatever.
Good work.
Not the biggest deal in the world. Level up. Melanie with 2 extra HP, I guess. I guess that's useful. Alright. Let's keep going here. Is there something right there? Weird that there's just one, like, kind of sticking out like that. I don't trust it. There's an enemy appearing.
About the enemy.
Freeze to death, nerd. Big 8. 28 DiMaggio. Alright. And just shoot him with an arrow. 40 damage. Nuts. Freeze and Ridus are scary when paired together. Bum 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 bum. Alright. Hello, what are you? Aha, I went the optional path, cool. Treasure chest. Protect against seal, bind stay ring. Ew, it only gives you 2 extra HP though as a stat. Eh. Don't know how I feel about that. That is not ideal. Alright, just big ol' ogre and everything again. Go ahead and freeze the slime. We've already got the ogre story, so once we kill enough of these slimes, we'll be good on all the enemies here. Fortunately, this isn't gonna kill. Ogre's still gonna get a chance to attack. Of course, I could. Because you're frozen, you don't get an action, so I guess I could attack you. I don't think it's gonna do 40 damage, but. Yeah. But, because you're frozen, you don't get an action, right? Yeah, no, you're still froze. Okay, cool. There we go. Yeah, I gotta remember that freezing does actually stun them too. I don't have to immediately pop the freeze to do the extra damage. Freeze is such a good status. It's so much better than, like, poison. I haven't really used paralysis much, but the fact that it stuns them so they don't get an action and it does double damage once you finally attack them makes it really strong. Whereas poison, like, it doesn't scale up. Since it just does a roll of the die and then they take that much damage, it's not useful as you get later in the game because Even doing 6 damage on the roll of the dice, which is the highest you can get, when an enemy has like 50-something HP is like nothing. It'd be better if it was like 10% of their HP or something. Ooh, thanks for the Inspire Elixir. Although I already have about 1 billion of them. Can sell it for money. Haven't really had to use them that much yet. I wonder if there were alternate difficulties for the game. I don't quite recall. Usually I go with like normal, because I usually feel like normal is probably the best thing to do when it's your first time playing any game. Because in my experience, like hard and stuff usually just requires that you grind a lot, but there are some games I put it on hard. Bravely Default, for example, and Bug Fables. I both played on the hard difficulty. Aw, come on, you live with 2 HP. Annoying. But yeah, those two I played on the hard difficulty, so it's not always correct, but normally I find normal is the best difficulty to go with when you're starting out. Really just depends on the game, though. I mostly just don't like when hard modes require that, like, you grind and stuff like that. If it's just you can do it, you just have to be really smart about it, I like that. Which is how Bug Fables and Bravely Default were. Alright. Let's go hit up the monster. Yeah, we finished off the slime category. Molten slimes are capable of melting steel and are predictably found near volcanoes. More surprising is their distaste for group behavior and yearning for the wider world. They don't like groups. Those who wander beyond the volcano are treated to a world that invites curiosity at every turn. Alas, most things burn to a crisp before the molten slimes can get close enough to touch. Oh, they're interested in the outer world, but they can't go there because they're too hot and they just burn everything. That's awful. Everything I touch dies! Alright, staircase. Nice of somebody to build some stairs in the volcano. That is very kind of them. Ooh, now it's like even hotter. You got like a mist covering this, or steam covering the screen, I guess. Smoke? Smoke.
Let's do
I eventually
this.
Got there. Hey, it said you guys didn't like groups. This isn't fair. My lore is broken. Immersion destroyed. Oh, it said they dislike groups. It didn't say they would never go in a group. And pop. Big damage.
Nice work.
I'm thinking I could maybe kill you if I use Lightning Strike. If I roll well, that's not gonna be enough, I don't think. Yeah. If you had crit. Oh, wait, no. Okay, cool. I mean, I planned that. Absolutely. I never doubted. Dead. Good job, Melanie. Big XP. There we go. Extra attack for Riddus. Puts you on par with everyone else. Ooh, treasure. Soothstone. Eh. Not really using those that much, although maybe I should start in battles and stuff.
A jet of lava erupts from the ground before you. You escape injury by the skin of your teeth, but the path ahead is now blocked.
Wow. Okay, so I need to find some more flash trees, huh? Maybe we can find a dead adventurer that had some on their corpse. Or we just go beat up the, Ivory Order and steal theirs? Or maybe they'll all be taking a nap inside a volcano and we can just steal it.
Don't hold back.
Oh, hey, there's the Pyro Wolf. That's the one that destroyed your house, Riddus. Or the type of one. Sorry to bring up bad memories, but big damage. Alright, and you're frozen. We can just loose an arrow on you. And... yeah, sure, let's spinning ray. Bum bum bum. Alright. Now you're gonna get a turn, but then you should die after that. I have to take a sip of water really quickly. Oh boy. That was needed. Still not totally better over my sickness, but I'm feeling a lot better at least. My throat and stuff just still isn't up to par yet. But we're getting there. I'm just happy I was able to keep recording during it because I like it so much. It sucks when I can't record. There's only been like one time where I was so sick that I couldn't record. And it blew. 1,500 gold. We got a lot of money now. Remember earlier on in the game, we were constantly running out of cash, but not the case anymore.
About the enemy.
Whoa, that's new. Hi? You're like a demon fluffball. Not something I thought I'd be seeing. Very weird. You have low defense. I think a spinning ray might take you out here. Oh, you're too fast. Oh! Okay, so you heal. Oh, geez, you know flamethrower. Okay. It's a pretty good fire attack. Ah, there we go. That's two dead. That one almost dead. No, that wasn't lucky. That was planned. Boom. I knew Ash would get the crit. Alright. More big XP. Those are some new enemies. Have we killed enough pyro wolves? Nope. Not yet. But we are getting there. Oh my god. So many enemies in this volcano. It's almost like nobody comes in here to clear them out. Of course, the Ivory Order probably likely did just come in here. So I'm surprised they haven't killed most of them. No freeze, but still big damage. If Ash goes before the slime, that'll be ideal. Fortunately, the fluff ball is also super fast. Yeah, they always attack Melanie because Melanie has the least defense. Was that a... I don't think that was enough. Yeah, the fluff ball's still alive. Only because it healed. If it hadn't healed, man. Ow. Yeah, you do have... a lot of attack damage. Ooh, big damage. Alright, Riddus, you're gonna finish off the evil fluff ball. And then Ash should be able to finish off the ogre. And dead. Cool. Pretty happy with that. Might need to start healing up in a second though. I suppose this is what I have the healing items for that I haven't been using the entire game. Alright. Up here. Yeah, there's the staircase, but what's over here? I want to see what's by that bridge that, or a lava spout that came up. Maybe there's a treasure chest or something.
And
okay, just two more slimes. Not super difficult. We did get the freeze. Yay. What was that? Yeah, I was about to say. That's death, isn't it? Yeah, that was big damage, narrator. Watch it, or I'll do it to you. Alright, lightning strike. I don't think you do enough to kill here, but... yeah, and definitely not if I roll a two. Or if I miss... okay. Well, thank you for that. Ow. The damn dodge, man. Well, I don't think that's gonna do anything, because there's... Yeah, if you crit, it's definitely gonna kill. Okay. It would've killed anyway. Yeah, we need to start healing up next fight. With, Eulogy. Alright. Okay, there's nothing down here. I just wanted to check. It's gonna bother me, man. I know it's nothing, but there we go. Beautiful. Alright, second floor. Wonder how many floors there are. Alright, like I said, we gotta heal up in this fight, though.
You can't help but chant, "It's hot. So hot," every couple of steps, as if conjuring a spell. You're just wasting energy, Melanie chides. Perhaps you could stand to learn a thing or two from her rational approach. Bruno seizes on the moment. "Yeah, this isn't even worth whining over," he says, flexing at you. "It is way too hot for this," Melanie screams, forgetting her own advice.
Okay, we're fighting amongst ourselves, not having a good time. But, I mean, a volcano would be very hot, so I can't really blame them. Whoa, flame turtle. Oh, allies and enemies defense. That's obnoxious.
Let's do this.
Let's try to kill you. Because otherwise you'll just heal up and generally be annoying. Or I'll just kill you in one hit, that's fine too.
That was lucky.
Yeah, it actually was. Alright, yeah, you can loose an arrow because that's free. That's like an evil turtle, it looks mean. I don't like it. I'm just gonna do a slash. This is the fight I plan to heal up on. Or try to, at least. You're a turtle, but you're also a fire turtle, so... Are you weak to this? No. Oh wait, yeah. But you just have super high defense. Alright, Eulogy. There we go. 10 HP for all. And let's go ahead and slash you. Okay, you have really high defense, so that's fine. Alright, let's get rid of you. Extra hard, apparently. Just kill you extra hard. Eulogy. Free heals all day. Good job, Riddus. And lightning strike. This might kill if you roll well. Yeah, no, that's not gonna do shit. Riddus just got sat on. Not ideal. Well, fire would do nothing to this, I'm pretty sure, so... God, it's so defensive. Oh well, more eulogies. Ooh, crit heal.
Excellent.
Alright, there we go. We're back up to full health. Now we can wholly focus on just... murdering you. Unfortunately, that's not enough, but it's
that
close. Poor Riddus. Alright, I think that's death? No, just barely not. Yeah, I see now. It was close, though. Boom. Now you're dead. Alright. Good stuff. I leveled up. Recover 2 HP after turn ends. Not amazing. 2 HP. Attack plus 15 damage, inflict attack down. Ooh, that's pretty good. Yeah, that's a really strong attack, actually. Bruno's best attack, I would say. Like, the other stuff Bruno has just isn't super useful, I feel. Oh, hi.
Just as you're about to faint from the oppressive heat, a heroic voice calls out to you. You turn and watch with wide eyes as beads of sweat glisten over his muscular body, only snapping out of your reverie when he asks if you're okay. According to the man, conditions will only worsen from here on out. He offers to lend you a comfy sleeping mat and blanket to rest with before continuing your journey.
Do we really want to sleep in this heat, though? Yeah, sure. Oh, wow, it actually heals me. Okay,
your
well, all that...
Your body is fully recovered, but now your body reeks of sweat. You thank the man before heading on your way.
Okay, so I didn't even have to do all that healing in that fight. They knew this was getting a little rough. More water time. Oh, just one of you guys, huh? And we get to gain 2 gems, at least. Let's go ahead and hit you with that. Riddus will be able to double shot you, so yes, I got the freeze. Okay, this'll probably kill, actually.
That was lucky.
Yeah, this will likely kill. Yup. Big dead. Thank you kindly. Not really worth a lot of XP when you're just by yourself, but whatever. Alright. Nothing going on here. Nope. Alright, what if we go back down here? Enemy. That's what. This group. Okay, that's useful. Since I'm not going to be doing fire damage to you jerks anyway. Got the freeze. Honestly, probably should have just killed you and froze the turtle. But whatever. The turtle is annoyingly tanky, so... Let's just hit all of you. Finish off that enemy and do baby bits of damage to the rest of you. Add 5-1 attack. Congratulations. Attack plus 5 damage. Ow! God, that thing hits hard. You never expect it. Okay, you're about to die. 2x damage. Oh, but now I'm not going to be able to use my thing like I wanted. Yeah, that was my mistake. Let's just attack you. Boom, 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 boom. Flame Breath. Have you used that before? Well, we take reduced damage from it, so... I don't particularly care. Good freeze. The freeze cheese. And boom. Dead. Out of here.
Good work.
Alrighty. Ash with the level up, a good one at that. Okay, level 20 is good level up. Everyone should work towards that before the boss. Preferably.
A wave of lava rushes past you, leaving a pile of boulders in its wake. You take a fortunate but ungainly fall backwards, but sadly you must find another route now.
Okay, well. I think I was supposed to run into that earlier, but I didn't. Probably gonna be some treasure over here, right? Yeah. Marine suit. Breastplate. Only the strong may don. Who is that for? I honestly don't know. Riddus, maybe? Yeah, you can equip it. Can you equip it? No. You can't, because you wear just armor. Where she wears like the half armor, basically. Alright. Well, more defense for Riddus. Continues to be my most defensive character, surprisingly. Given that they're like an archer class. But whatever. Jump to the third floor, yeah. I guess it's because she can wear the same kind of equipment that Mar wears, and obviously Mar is a tank, so... That's pretty good equipment, if you're looking to be defensive. 2,000 gold. I will take it. Enemy. Have I gotten all of the monster stories? I don't think I have for these turtles. I also don't think I have... No, I did for the slime. I haven't for the little murder fluff balls or the pyro wolves yet, though. I don't believe. God, having to fight two of these turtles is rough. It's real rough. Let's just focus on the ogre. Yeah, I'm gonna leave that one frozen. We're just gonna do a lightning strike. Thanks for the one. You idiot. Ow, three times? Oh my god. Okay, Melanie might die here. Yep. Okay, I don't recall that thing ever using that. That's... interesting. Well, she's gonna get back up after this, so I don't need to use an Inspire Elixir. I think you... 30... I think the spinning attack from Ash may kill here. Or I could use Tri-Blade and probably kill the turtle. Eh, let's just use this. Yeah, I killed the guy in the middle at least. That's what I wanted. The two turtles are still alive, unfortunately, but... Now that I know that stupid ogre can use Pulverize, I'm, like, more scared of it. Yeah, we got this. Alright, quick shot. Oh yeah, we do like shit for damage. I should have just killed the other one. Oh my god, you keep rolling ones, damn you! If that had been a six, you would have died. Or even a five. Yeah, there you go. Attack Ash, please. Don't attack Riddus. Riddus, mate. Okay, no. You're trying to finish both of us off. Will this even kill? Okay, if you crit it, will. It was gonna kill anyway. Honestly, let's just go ahead and use one of these salves, eh? Riddus has higher defense, so I'll put it on Ash. There we go. Just to make sure we don't die. The enemies here are a tad bit more difficult than a lot of the enemies we've been running into thus far. Nothing's ever really gave me a run for my money. Except for that area when I first walked into it and just got blasted by some really strong critters. Alright. Maybe I should put heal back on. Zero elements, attack plus 30 damage to all enemies? Oh my god, that one would require like charging to get to though. That's nuts. Really powerful though. There we go. Stupid magma tortoise. Magna. Alright. That thing is strong, dude. Yeah, we don't have your flip side yet, right? Nope. Still need to kill some more of you. One had best keep their distance from these tortoises, which nest in volcanic areas and fire jets of searing magma from their shells. Should one survive the approach, stroking the tortoise's head triggers states of low, medium, and high heat. Surely somewhere a chef is coveting this sentient stove. Interesting, you're a stove. Weird. Oh, cool, and she got healed because she leveled up. Oh, that's amazing. That is very, very good. Alright, let's go ahead and use a quality salve on Riddus. There we go. Good job, Melanie. Getting that level up just in time. Alright. We're slowly but surely making our way through this damn volcano. I also am doing a longer episode for this today because, once again, I just have some spare time, so why not? People seem to be enjoying it, so I can do some longer episodes if I have the time.
Let's do this.
Freeze. Die, please. Let's just freeze you and then focus on taking out the stupid ogre before it uses pulverize again. That was just rude when you did that, ogre. Lightning strike, yeah. If only I had enough for Triblade. We finally roll a 6, though, when it... I was about to say it doesn't matter, but no, I think that just killed now. Good shit, Ash. Good
nice
shit.
Work.
Alright, let's hit you with another freeze. Because this will do weak damage and double damage, so... Oh yeah, big dead. Big dead. Good stuff. Alrighty. Now where to? There's a lot of area over here that we haven't explored, but... The staircase is right over there. We just kind of walk straight through it. Oh. Okay, well that
the
takes away some.
Give way to a rush of lava. You just barely manage not to fall in. Time to find an alternate route.
Okay, so that was the wrong way to go. And that did take out a lot of those spaces. Okay. So, what's down this way then, treasure? Well, besides an enemy. But there's probably treasure. And I oh cool, another magma wolf. Awesome. I'm gonna focus on the wolf, because you have flamethrower, which is kind of terrifying. Fortunately I didn't freeze you. But not the biggest deal, I suppose. Let's attack you. And then of course you get a turn. Yeah. I don't think Spinning Ray will- Oh my god! You're faster than me. Okay. Didn't know that was the case. This should kill, though. Good stuff. Now we just gotta deal with the stupid turtle. Tortoise, sorry. Oh no, that's a dead Ash. He just got his ash kicked. Alright, it's up to you two. What does paralysis do? Does it make it so they just can't act? Basically just the worst version of freeze? Yeah, seems to be all it does. Okay. Yeah, just the worst version of freeze, basically. Still useful though, because I can just wail on them without them being able to do anything. Cool. Still not using those Inspire Elixirs. HP and speed. Cool. I was mashing A there, so I was afraid I was gonna miss it. There we go. Pyro Wolf and Fireball. Good. Yeah, I'm actually having to use my items here. It's a bit of a surprise. But this is quite a long dungeon, and the enemies are no joke. Alright, monsters. Revered among their peers, these moody furballs openly display their contempt for the world by dyeing their fur red and donning terrifying masks. They are not your average puffballs, adventurers, knowing nothing of their pride hunt and... Adventurers, knowing nothing of their pride, hunt and make an example of them with each horrid kill. Wow. Dark. Alright, now the wolf. The flames engulfing these wolves are said to burn until the wolf perishes. As such, one nation took to engraving the beasts on talismans as a symbol of long life. A pack of pyro wolves lost in the forest risk burning it all down to the ground. Keenly aware of this, the forest dwellers hunt the wolves before they douse the flames. Ah, yeah. So when the fire starts, they have to kill all the wolves and then they get rid of the flames. Because there's no point in getting...
You've spent so long in here, even I'm starting to sweat.
Sorry, narrator. I gotta get all the treasure and everything, man. Wait, there's multiple staircases? This I did not expect. I don't need any more of those. I do not. Alright, I just kinda wanna finish this floor off, and then I think we'll go ahead and end the episode here. But first, we must finish. Even more enemies off. I want to freeze the slime. The slime has that attack that makes us weak to fire damage. And that's not ideal in this area, so... None of that, please. Could you kill with this? With like a 6 and a crit? Nah, I don't even think you would've. Pretty good damage still, though. Ow. Oh, okay, you have high defense, good. That's the perfect character for you to attack. Yes, everyone gang up on Riddus. Riddus has great defense. Alright. Let's freeze again. Yes, got the freeze. Good. This is gonna be some big damage once it gets to Ash's turn. That killed. You know what? No, just don't spinning ray. Slash that one. And then we'll have Melanie cast freeze on this last tortoise, which should do a shit ton of damage because it's double. We don't need the freeze. It should die. Yeah, there we go. Good stuff. And there we are. Alright, I just want to clear out the area, okay? No more battles. You're not allowed. Game. I'm warning you. Don't you do it. Ah! Of course it would. Well, we pretty much uncovered the entire area now, so... I just have to defeat these nerds. And then we'll be good. Sorry, Wolfie, gonna have to put you down. Boom. Alright, now we just gotta focus on the furball. I wish there was an ability we could get that made us start with more gems. You kinda have to slowly ramp up.
That was lucky.
Okay, I can kill both of them. If I, use my spinning ray here. Which seems like a good idea. Still no damage to the damn turtle. God. They're so damn tanky. Oh, I don't have enough for the freeze. That's not good. Alright, well, we'll just paralyze it. Same thing, basically. As long as this hits, that is. Okay, cool. Yeah. Now it can't attack me. Ooh, extra damage.
Excellent.
Good stuff. Alright, just kind of wail on it slowly. It's not going to get a chance to attack or anything, so... I might drop a eulogy here. Yeah, let's do that. And then Ash can finish it off. I think. Well, if I use the lightning attack, he should be able to. Yeah, this should finish it, right? There we go. Oh, the crit definitely mattered there. Absolutely needed that crit to kill. 100%. Alrighty. Well, I do believe we are basically done with this floor now. I'll just do a quick survey of the rest of the map. Make sure we're not missing anything here. And yeah, I think we're basically done. There's two staircases. One of them goes down, one of them goes up, so... But I'll leave that for next time. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Voice of Cards, and I'll see you then.